Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will introduce you to tools, Ollama and Pinecone. Ollama is a tool which allows you to run and do experimentations LLM in your local environment. Very useful, you will see, it's quite interesting tool. Which again allow you to experiment with different LLMs, different flavors, and for different activities like creating embeddings, chat, or generating tests, or what we know as completion. And Pinecone, which is a tool as a vector database, is a state of the art vector database which allow you to create store vectors and then on use them to do queries or integrate it as a component in a chain, in a rack component in a chain. So let's move to the topic. So I created a Jupyter notebook as usual. This time I'm running it local. If you are following me on YouTube, you will see that many times I'm using Google Colab. This time, as we are working local, this is the purpose of Ollama. I already as well recorded a couple of the videos where I use Ollama in the past. You can watch them on the channel. But today I will be focusing on that. Also the connection with or the interaction with Pinecone. And finally, we will create a small sample of how to do RAG and use both technologies to create embeddings and then upload these embeddings to Pinecone, to a Pinecone index, and then use them to do a query and return some outputs. I put you here some links, interesting links about Ollama, the Docker container, how to create as well Docker Compose files. There is a extensive community of the Ollama Hub, where there is people extending the features of Ollama. I put you there as well the link. Very good and extensive as well documentation. You can install it in Mac, in Windows, in Linux, Dockerize as well with other components. In this case, I will show you this version that's created for a component of the Ollama community, which comes UI which allow you to admin and to manage the Ollama container and to load models, create new models, etc. One of the good things allow you Ollama is to you can load models into the platform, into the tool, in different formats: Python, Safe Extensor, and GGUF. This is the new model, the new format, file types that allow you to load models in small GPUs and also save it with using less space in a local file system. This format was released last year. At that time, it's becoming one of the most used format, especially for inference. I wanted to make you aware that the Ollama is just designed to do inference. You cannot train anything on that platform, and it's a very good tool, as I said, for experimentation, to create a POC, to compare different models with the same data set and make some benchmarks or comparison in between models. And the good thing as well, as I said, it can run in a local computer. I had a conventional desktop with a GPU, NVIDIA GeForce 1650 with 4 GB of memory, and then on the enable even to load in my machine a Llama 2 7 billion or a Mistral 7 billion and do inference, which is well, in my opinion, is quite impressive what is possible to do. Again, you can do this, you can, and in my case, I'm running this in Docker, in Docker containers, which is an extra load for my machine. You can install this also locally, but this is currently very well documented here on the documentation, but today I will show you how to do it in a Docker container. So you can interact with the tool via command line, via REST API, and also if you use the Docker container, the Docker Compose file, you can interact as well using the application.com to do experimentation and admin the Ollama tool. Okay, so you have a model library, something similar, not in the amount of models to what you have available in Hugging Face. You can access here. So there is multiple models that you can upload into your Ollama tool, into your Ollama container. If you click in one of the models, it will give you some additional information, how to interact with the model, etc. So one very good thing, at least in my opinion, is that you can run as well these models into your CPU. They are using quantization 4 bits. And then on, for example, Llama 2 in this case come with all these flavors, all these versions, which is really impressive. So if you look at the number of models you have here, you can do experimentation with a single platform, a single tool. You can exchange models easily. It's obviously taking sometimes removing the model from memory and loading a new one, but well, again, it's possible to do in your conventional, into your local computer. I don't have a very or powerful computer, and I'm able to run. I didn't run all of them. I didn't try all of them. I just try. Mistral, Llama 2, and Queen, and Orca Mini for now, and all of them perform correctly. Again, you need to wait a little bit just to exchange models in memory. You will see now later on how it's done. It's automatically done. You don't need to do anything. You just need to specify the model on the as a tag when you use one of the available libraries, when you use the library from Ollama, or you use the integration with the LangChain or with other tools. And this is done automatically, but again, it's very simple to do. You don't need to care about the code behind. It's everything integrated in a tool, and it's really easy to do and to work with, and especially for, as I said, for experimentation and kind of small POC that you can run at home. And experimentation is really, really nice tool. I highly recommend you to use it. Well, again, we can go to the documentation again. Models, again, you can import models in different formats, GGUF, and also PyTorch and SafeTensors. You can create or transform your models with from PyTorch SafeTensor to GGUF. But I didn't try that. I didn't find so far. It's in the documentation, but still didn't try this functionality. For now, I just experimenting all the features that the tool have. you can create a prompt for every model, kind of the default prompt. Just specify here, for example, the model tag, the some of the parameters like temperature equal one, and also a system prompt to interact with the model. Later on, I will show you. You can publish this as an entry point, and you can make simply experimentation with that. It's quite useful, kind of define templates and for different experiments. Again, you can interact with the model with the tool, using the CLI, or you can use the API. So the API is a REST. In RESTful interface, RESTful API, using FAST API, and replicate the behavior of every command that you can do via command line. There is essentially three main entry points. One is generate, the other one is chat, and the other one is embeddings. Generate is to run queries against the model, like you see here. You send the, to generate, you send the model, and you send the prompt. And then you will get an answer, and then you can see here the answer, blah blah blah. They say you can interact with the chat. Again, similar. And also, if you scroll down, you have again embeddings. So you had all create a model, list the model. I will show you later on in the command line as well. Information, copy, delete, pull and push is you can pull a model, models that you have available on the model registry, and you can create your model, fine tune a model as we did with the fine-tuning the Mistral 7B for COT. You can take the safe tensors, you can push these models, this model fine-tuned the similar what we do with pushing the model to Hugging Face Hub. We push it here to Ollama Hub, and then you make the model as well available to the community. And generate embeddings, you can use any model that you had there to generate embeddings as well. In the exercise that we will do later, we will use a Llama 2 model to generate embeddings for size 4096 dimensions, and we will use this embeddings. We will upload these embeddings to the Pinecone vector database, and then we will use this vector database to do some queries, a kind of the RAC component, and use it. Okay, so to to create the here in the in this repository, that one here, we had the Docker Compose. This is also provided by a member of the community. It's very easy to implement. Support with GPU or without GPU, it's up to you how you want to run the models. Obviously, you run without GPU, it's slightly slower, but be conscious as well that sometimes, especially if you are exchanging models, you have to consider the penalty of exchanging models, and also offloading the data to memory. In my case, I make some experiments with my 4 GB GPU. Sometimes with models like the Llama 2, you can use it to generate embeddings, but you cannot use the complete context windows. You need to send, you cannot send very long text with 4,000 tokens, for example, to the API, because you get a out of memory in CUDA, no, in your GPU. So to use it, I need to reduce the size of the chunks in which I split the text, and that way I was able to create the embeddings. This is just an example, and again, it can help you to understand how to link the different components for a production environment. But well, in a local environment, I think for the big models had some limitations. In other tests I make, I use the queen model, that one with this very small model with only 0.5 billions of the queen. This one, there is very small model here. And this model, for example, produces embeddings of 1024 dimensions, and this model runs very well in CPU or GPU, and it was very fast producing embeddings for this model, and also using it for even conventional chatting or compilations. Okay, to install the container, you just simply git clone the repository, you move to the container, or Llama Docker in this case, and you just execute this command. The Docker compose YAML file that comes with the repository in my installation didn't work. I had a Windows 11 with Windows System Linux in a Debian 9, and it didn't work. It didn't work with GPU. So what it didn't work was the Docker Compose or Llama GPU. So what I did finally is adapt the Docker Compose YAML with the GPU support, and after that it worked without any problem, just running the command that I'm showing you here, Docker compose minus f docker compose YAML app minus d. So that work, once you run the command, it will create the compose with three containers: the Ollama container itself, this is the tool itself, and this tool is a web interface, and this is an application that run additionally for experimentation that you can configure and install models, create prompts, whatever you need to do. I will show you now in a while. If you go to Ollama, you can see here you enter in the logs. This I've been running this for a while already, so yeah. And then you can see here how it's loading the models in memory. It's quite extensive, the printing. This model was in that case a Llama. It's in format. All the models, especially you downloaded from the Ollama hub, will come in this format, GGUI version 3, which again is suitable for or switch, at least in my case, you see the space, the size of the model is 3.56 gigabytes, which switch into my GPU and is able to do inference. But as I told you before, even I had some additional free space on my GPU, I had other applications running on my GPU. Probably I can show you this. I don't know if the available size to run effectively inference is very small in my GPU. If you had a bigger CPU, you can try with the bigger chunks or with bigger or even with bigger models, no? You need to check what is the size. You can check this as well on the on the library, and it suits, for example, let's take a look, one of the biggest I saw here, that is Falcon. There is the Falcon 4TB or even bigger. So we have here, you see here, this is a Falcon. The default Falcon, if I don't remember wrong, is the 7B. Yeah. This is a 40, the 40B had 24 gigabytes with quantization 4 bits. So, well, this is obviously I cannot run it in my machine. You can take that one, this as well not. Yeah, probably, yeah, those models, and none of them are going to suit in my machine. But yeah, take a look to this. If you had a bigger GPU, the Orca ones, yeah, you had the 7 billions, we can load it on memory. Different thing is if I will be able, again, because for example you had Chrome running in your machine, or you had Teams or other tools are working on memory, and this well, is consuming some GPU as well, no? In my case, again, for what I'm seeing in the GPU display, I had Chrome, I had Brave, I had Skype, several Google Drive as well running in the GPU. Probably they are not consuming too much, but yeah, Task Manager, we can take a look. Not all the performance, yeah. So my GPU is 4 gigabytes and already 1.7 without a model uploaded. Well, I don't know what is already loaded in memory now, but yeah, it's not very big. But again, you can experiment in any case with many of the models that you have there, no? If you go to exit, you can go to a command line interface. I just run here bash, and yeah, you just enter here execute bash. Ollama, just executing Ollama, you can interact with the tool via command line. Start the server, create a model for a model file, show the information of a model, just take Ollama list, and then you have the list of the model that you have available here. You can do then Ollama show and take one of the model, for example this one, or just write it Llama 2 7B. Oh, sorry. Ah, sorry. System, exactly. So, oops, sorry. So, no, nothing there. That's license. Oops. Yeah. Okay, so you can interact here again with the tool via command line and also via API. You can run a model. Running a model means loading in memory. If you run a model and you don't have, to run a model, you need to know the tag of the model that you want to use. If you don't have the model in your local model registry, it will download automatically the model to your local registry. If you want just to download the model, you can do a Ollama pull. If you have a model that is, you want to push a model to the model registry of Ollama, you can use Ollama pull. Ollama push is very similar kind of the GIT, and list models we already tried to copy a model. This is useful when you want to make a copy, a personalized copy of your model and push it to the Ollama Ollama hub. And well, that's that's all, copy and remove, no? It is exactly all these commands, as you saw on the documentation, you have it here available as well, and you can just simply send a request with curl or with Python or with your favorite language, and you can do exactly the same with them, no? Okay. Later as well, together with the Ollama container comes this web UI, and then the web UI is, well, it's for those who are familiar with OpenAI, with ChatGPT, you will find it very similar. And then here you have an settings, you can interact, personalize the tool with parameters. By default, there is some parameters which we send. These are the parameters by default that we send to when we generate, when we interact with the LLM in chat or in completion or in generate mode. This is the commands. Also, there is some of these commands apply as well to the embeddings interface. You can manage, admin your models. Here you just can delete them. You can pull a new model, just write the tag and it's pulled it automatically from the model. And this is experimental, to be honest, I didn't try, no. Well, again, you can take a look. There is multiple options, multiple personalizations. And at the same time, if you go to the repository, you have here as well a lot of integrations with many tools for web and desktop terminals, or to access to the Docker or to the Docker via command line, with some databases, package managers help, it's very common, would use as well in Kubernetes. Libraries, the main and more important with LangChain. You have also here the information available in LangChain. It's fully integrated with LangChain, which is fantastic. And, sorry, some mobile frameworks and some extension plugins as well. So there is plenty of people working on this community as well, so you have to have an eye on the tool. It's quite interesting framework. So here we have chats. You can set up a chat with one of your models. You just take a model here, create a new chat. You just choose one of the models that you had available in your repository. You previously had to set up a model, and then just you send a message. This is I suppose that everybody who is watching these videos know what is ChatGPT. This is pretty similar. The good thing here, you can if you have different models here, you just can select one and start a chat with them. No? The only problem, you have to be just concerned or aware of the limitations of your local machine, and then if you decide to exchange models or to use different models, there is a transition time that the tool need, no, to download or to remove the model from the GPU and load the new model, and you can once the model is loaded, you can start interacting with that. Model files, here you can create, you can fine tune, for example, a model and create a model file, and then on push this new model to the model community, to the Ollama Hub community. Prompts, here you can create a specific prompts for you. I show you this on the documentation. You can decide for this, you can create multiple models or multiple prompts for the same model, and this is just, it will create a command, and this command you can interact with then via API or via command line. Documents, this you can add new documents or information to your as context for your completions or for your chat, and the way to do this is through this interface. This you can do it as well via command via command line. And that's all. I will not touch that. Well, we can do a test here. It's just very simple. But this will mean that we are going to change the model that we had in memory. I had in memory Ollama 2, and then on now it will start to remove the memory, the model that we have in memory, and it will offload the memory that the model, the new model to the GPU, and then on make the generation, create the answer to you. This is gonna take some time, at least on my machine, so we will move to what I did on the notebook, and then we will come back here. No, this I'm using one of the models I had. Whatever, you will see how it works. Here for the now we can go to Pinecone. Pinecone is the vector database. Is again today probably one of the most used, especially for production environments. It's quite scalable, and also you can be used in a serverless. Very easy to use. It provides the interface or development APIs for Python and TypeScript and JavaScript. So creating an index is pretty simple. You can create a project and a simple index. You are allowed to use only one index for free, but you can delete it and create it any time you want. And then for this demo, I just create an index. You just create let's remove it. Later we will create it again, but yeah, we just remove this, and then create an index. You just create the main dimensions of the vector. In my case is 4096. I'm gonna use the Llama 2 model with 7 million, and had an embedding of 4096. You have here the metric to use when you do some queries. At least you had you are gonna use one of the predefined models that they had in the available on the library. It just you just select it, and it just set the configuration for you. Here, as we are on the starter layer we cannot use the other. We can, if you want to move to pods or serverless, pods is dedicated VMs for your vector databases, and serverless is using serverless technologies, Kubernetes in that case, I suppose, or something similar. But those two options are, you need to introduce a credit card, and I didn't want to do it. It's up to you if you want to test this. There is no big changes, especially from started to pods. There is no big changes in the way to use it. In serverless, you need to configure to set up a couple of additional parameters for using with serverless, and import an additional class. We are on the starter tier, so we had 100,000 vectors for this test, and if you want to do some additional tests, it's more than enough. So you can choose as cloud provider. This is the provider which is acting on the backend to provide the infrastructure. You can use Google, Amazon, or Azure. That's not a problem. In the starter tier, we only can use Google, and only can use as well Iowa GCP. It's, again, it's just a try. Take a look and decide yourself if you want to do. If you want to start using serverless as in other technologies, you can see here they give you $100 of credits. And I think documentation wise is quite extensive as well. There is many examples, and again it's integrating with the main libraries, especially with LangChain and OpenAI. It's direct integration with them, though both of them recognize Pinecone, and yeah, it's pretty simple to integrate both. And then you can take a look to the pricing. Yeah, it's kind of case that you are interested in how to use it. Yeah, personal dimensionality, namespace, yeah, depending the case use scenario. You have here, yeah, price per month, queries per month, yeah, and you calculate total month. So one namespace, 1 million, 1 million vectors, number of queries, number of rights, the price is, well, nothing, essentially. So if you pretend to use this an application in production, just keep an eye on this, because, well, I think it's worth it to consider, depending on your use case. As I say in many of my videos, most of the components I need to build cannot work, have to work in on premises, so I cannot use these technologies. That's, but for most of the other companies, they can use this service that is provided with an internet connection, and it's nice, really, really good though. Okay, so we go here, we create the index, and that's it. Now for now we don't have any vector before, exactly, we don't have vectors, we don't have namespace, and then on now in the notebook we will create this. We import the libraries we need. This is just one book I downloaded, the Great Gatsby. I just create some chunks, as I mentioned you before. I need to create small chunks because it's not, I overflow the memory of the GPU. Doing this chunks, I create 270 documents. You can see here. I use the Ollama embeddings class of the LangChain to create the embeddings. And this is gonna do everything for you. This is expecting to have a Ollama library installed in your local computer, and it's going to connect to this port. If you look at exactly to the local host in the port 11434. So it's expecting the class assume that you are gonna have this already running, and it's not, it will fail. Simply it will return an error. You can specify here, there is multiple other, yeah, you have here, you can specify other ports. This is if you change the exposed port in the Docker file, you can use another base URL. It's up to you. For what I see, you can run as well this in a hosting solution that they had some agreement with them. But well, in this case, by default, it's gonna make a connection to the interface that is exposed by the Ollama Docker. So you just create this. I just here extracting the page content of the launching document and creating a leak. So here in this test I did, I'm creating embeddings one by one. You can send all of them in a go, but as I had some problems, it was returning null from some of the chunks. I decided to do one by one. I know that is not efficient, but okay. This way, I just check. I try to to catch it, I get a vector with size 0. With size 0, no, that return a none because it was a GPU overflow. But usually what you do is here in this command, in text, you send the list of text. So in this case, the complete list I created here. You send it in a simple go to the class in this function, and then it will create one by one all the embeddings. As you can see here, every embedding takes 6 seconds to be created, but again, once this is the first one, it takes 4 minutes 23 seconds, and this is because we need to in that case I was with this model. Where is the GUI here? Exactly, you see here the model already return an answer, and then now we have this model in memory. We can take a look here. So we had this model in memory, and it is, let me go to the bottom. Yes, we go to generate. Yeah, and then here, exactly, you see all the logs. Yeah, if we now try to run that, we tried again. If we try to generate an embedding using the Llama 2, it needs to remove this model, the model that currently is in memory. It has to remove it and load the Llama 2 in memory to do the inference. We will do this now, it's automatically done, I will show you. But the thing I wanted to explain you is, if you the first model took a while up to this operation is done, no? The rest took only 6 seconds. So I'm not going to generate them again, you can try as your own. So the size of the vector again is 4096. This is the length of the vectors. Also important, you need to create a key to access to the Pinecone service. It's just simply as in other tools like OpenAI, is exactly the same. I put the key in a .env file, and I simply get this from the environment, and here we are importing the Pinecone. You need to install the Pinecone client. I think it's here, it's an wrong as well. Indexes connect, you just need to connect. You have here an example, very simple example as well. And you said you can, again, when you do a query, this is one of the fantastic things Pinecone have. You can introduce metadata and then use this metadata to narrow or to create efficient queries and to localize efficiently the information that you have in your vector database. This is quite nice, the metadata, and then you can use the filter in your queries and use the stuff that you have in your metadata just to narrow and make more efficient queries. Here you have an example again, Shell, Node, or Python. But for Python, mainly you need to install the library. So we go here. we create the Pinecone object. We just set the index, and here we just create a list of dictionaries which contains an ID for every vector that we are going to upload to Pinecone. The values, which essentially is the vector. Here I'm just iterating with zip, zipping to lists, three lists in this case. And also in metadata, I simply copy the data that I use to create the specific vector. And then I just push in data every 25 dictionaries in chunks of 25 to make it a little bit more efficient. It's true as well that you have a limit. In my case was 200. If you make a push of more, in my case, but remember that I'm introducing here the text in this attribute, and also my vector is 4096 dimensions, which is really big. So I will push this, it will not take a couple of minutes. I will make a pause and then I will be back. Okay, that's all. It takes again 1 minute and 20 seconds. And then on that we can come back now to Pinecone, and you can see here we had 270 vectors, and you can take a look here. Yeah, for the moment we didn't do any use. And now what we are gonna do is just I create this helper function that I'm just creating an embedding from an arbitrary text. Essentially we will be able to use multiple texts depending what we send here on the query. It's expecting a list, and then now you will see here it's gonna take a while, because as I said, now at some point it's downloading now the current model that is in memory, is removing the model from there and uploading the new one. Again, this is gonna take a while. We will catch the time. It's now 17:39, and then once it's done, I will be back. And we will finish the demo. You can see here now how the model starts to be loaded in memory, and in some seconds we will see how the model the tool directly invoke the embeddings API. Okay, it's done. So it took a while, so it has grown from 39:56 to 43:21, practically 4 minutes, up to the tool exchange the model and generate embeddings. Again, this is only happening the first time. If you execute again, it's gonna take less time, 4 minutes, 20 seconds. Probably if we do it now again, it's gonna take less time. So you can take, it's already done. It's taking just 5 seconds. Yeah, this again, this is a small disadvantage, but at the same time, it allows you to do your experimentations with multiple models in a single, in a simple domestic computer as I have. No? Your embedding, this is what we return. Now I just wanna make a query to the using the our index. I using the query method in the vector I just send the embed what the Ollama return me, the embedding of this query, who is the Great Gatsby. It's just a silly thing, but well, I just wanted to show you. And then again, here in the query, you can introduce the metadata, not only that in the response include the metadata and also the vector, whatever you can introduce here. There is also multiple commands, multiple parameters, and again you can use the filter, and you can also use namespace. These options are not available on the, so namespace is not available in the free tier, but filters you can use it. You can try with multiple documents and create, if you want, some metadata kind of how to drive the search or the similarity function across the different chunks and across the different across the different vectors that you have in the database. For now, we just simply want to test. You see, it's very quickly. The return is an object from the Pinecone library. You can transform this to a dictionary. The dictionary comes with three main keys. You have the uses of this query, namespace. Let's check how much we use. It's interesting to see how much we use here. But again, I need the free, but probably it will tell us 6 Unix. And in matches, you get here we ask the top K3 members, more close using similarity to the vector that we send as query, and then on I just here printing the first one, and here I'm doing a printout of everything that the score, the metadata, the score. This is also the cosine similarity, because we define our index using vector similarity, cosine similarity as metric to be evaluated when you send a query. I don't remember what is this, but it doesn't matter. It was cosine similarity. That's all. You can see here it returning the score. In the response per match, you receive the ID. We didn't say that return the vector, so the values is empty. And here the metadata. As I told you before, you may have here in the metadata not only an attribute, and here I just introduce the text. Very lazy, because I can't do exactly the same without sending that in a query, and also saving some space on the vector database. But here the purpose of the metadata is just to create some tags that allow you to refine and fine-tune the search that Pinecone is doing in the backbone of the tool. That's all. I hope you like it. Yes, it's quite interesting tool. I didn't check so far if the outputs are correct or not. It's not the purpose of this demo, just to show you how these two technologies, the two wonderful technologies, work. No? Especially I like Ollama, because again, allow me to do experiments very quickly, easy, without cost. Even I don't need to connect to Google Colab, it has some cons, at least in my case, with my GPU, I cannot do everything I would like. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching, and as usual, if you like the video, just give me a like, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, it's now time to do it. Thank you very much.